Okay, so welcome back, and now we're going to talk about division. So we're going to division of whole numbers, and so again, just like we saw with addition and subtraction, there's a relationship between multiplication and division, okay? So first of all, there are many different ways to denote division using symbols. So this says 3 divided by 12. This you can read two different ways. You can read 12 divided into 3, or you can say 3 divided by 12. This also says 3 divided by 12. This is the divisional bar, right? Division bar. So 3 divided by 12. So fractions are division symbols, okay? So when we read this 3 twelfths, we could also read this as 3 divided by 12. And then, of course, this is another way of showing the same thing, 3 divided by 12. Okay, now, the different pieces of division, okay, is we have the divisor, right? So this is the divisor, that which is dividing or breaking the group up, right? In division, we're breaking a whole up into pieces, right? So this is the divisor. Okay, so basically this is saying I want to break this up into 12 equal pieces. Okay, this is called the dividend, that which is being divided. Right, and then the answer that goes up here is called the quotient. Okay, those are the three pieces of a division problem. Also, when you look at division, division can also be looked at as a in terms of multiplication too. Because when we say 12 divided by 4 equals blank, what we mean is, hey, 4 times what will give me 12? So when I say, when I look at it as a multiplication problem where I've got this missing factor here, and I say, okay, well, what do I need to stick in here in order to make this true? Well, the answer would be 3, which means that if I take 12 and divide it into 4 equal pieces, each piece, each group, will contain 3 objects or 3 pieces, okay? And so we end up at 3, okay? And so that's the idea. Now, one of the other things, again, we have our division table, right? Make sure you know your single division table, right? Up through 9, right? Know your division, okay? 9 divided by 1, right? And so on, okay? Make sure you know your multiplication tables for single digits and your division tables for single digits. Now for the division, it only goes up to 9, right? Well, you can actually go up to 12, right? Again, you can memorize those easily. Or even 13, okay? So you can do that for other ones, but again, but what happens when you get larger numbers? Well, then we need something more to use, and that's where the division algorithm is going to come in, and I'm going to show you those steps next. Have a great day.